Sometimes a workout can get a bit confusing with all these exercises targeting different groups of muscles. Few people know that if you want to build muscles all over your body, it's enough to know just three exercises and do them correctly. Number 1. Ab Wheel Roller Exercises. The great thing about the ab wheel roller is that this device helps you to strengthen tons of different muscles. Every time you do an ab wheel workout, you work more than 20 muscles. Such a workout trains your abs, hip flexors, obliques, lower back, upper back, shoulder, and arm muscles. It's also much more effective than good old crunches because it generates a higher amount of muscle activity in your obliques and abs. On top of that, with the help of an ab wheel, you learn to keep balance. Strengthening your abdominal muscles leads to core stabilization. If you do everything correctly, you'll make your spine stronger and get rid of lower back pain. But once again, it's crucial to perform the exercise correctly. Lower yourself onto your hands and knees, and make sure you have enough free space in front of you. Grip the ab roller with both hands and transfer your weight onto it. You can also cross your legs at the ankles behind your back and lift them off the floor or exercise mat. It will make the movement more challenging and stabilize you. Strengthen your core, squeeze your glutes, and start moving forward by rolling the ab wheel in front of you. One of the most important things here is not to change your spinal alignment throughout the move. Try to roll out as far as you can while keeping your lower back straight. Pause for several seconds in that position. The longer you manage to hold it, the more work your muscles will do. Now, start to move back. To do this, you should tighten your abs and core muscles to help you roll the wheel back towards your knees. If you're great at ab wheel rollouts, you can take the exercise to the next level. To do so, stand straight on your feet and start doing the exercise from this position. If you decide to go for it, remember to squeeze your glutes, round your upper back, lock your arms, and move your pelvis back a bit. Be careful not to repeat the most common mistakes people do during rollouts. Your bottom shouldn't sag toward the ground during the exercise. You need to keep your back, from head to tailbone, as straight as you can. Roll out slowly and steadily. Your arms should be straight and even. This will help you prevent the wheel from spinning out of control. Number 2. Jumping. There are two kinds of jumps, vertical and long ones. Both of them are effective for working the lower part of your body, namely your leg and hip muscles. Your arms participate in this jumping workout as well, because you swing them to gain momentum and use them to slow yourself down right before landing. Jumping also challenges your nervous system, makes you stronger, and improves your endurance and athletic abilities. Your vertical jump will be the highest if you jump off 2 feet. This way, the strength of your legs will literally push you off the ground. First of all, bend your knees as if you're sitting on an imaginary chair. Make sure your feet are approximately shoulder-width apart, and your knees are bent at 60 degrees. This way, you'll have the most power for your jump and, at the same time, won't injure your knees. Right before a jump, make sure your knees are positioned over your toes. When you jump, your back should be perfectly straight. Only in this way will you prevent a back injury. It's even more crucial to land correctly. Remember that you should land on the balls of your feet. Only after that should you roll onto your heels. By landing on flat feet, you can easily twist your ankle. Also, slightly bend your knees right before landing. It will absorb the impact and you won't hurt your knees. Long jumps. When jumping vertically, you use both legs. Before doing long jumps, it's better to find out which is your dominant foot and jump off it. The best place to practice long jumps is in a sand pit so you can avoid injuries. After you've kicked off the ground, thrust your hips forward as much as you can. This movement will help you to fly a longer distance. You should land as softly as you can. Your knees should be a bit flexed, and your ankles are supposed to be straight. Also, never use your wrists if you fall. Let the sand break your fall. Number 3. Rope climbing. When you climb a rope, you work muscles all over your body. This exercise not only develops your upper body, but also improves your coordination and agility. It strengthens your biceps, upper and lower back, forearms, shoulders, and abs. Grip the rope with your hands. One of them should be above the other, and the rope should be positioned between your legs. Start pulling yourself up by bending your arms at the elbows. Every time you reach the top of the lift, grab a higher part of the rope with your lower hand. Repeat these actions until you reach the top of the rope. After you reach the top, move down in the same manner. If it feels too hard to move up the rope using only your hands, you can use your legs as well. If you're an inexperienced rope climber, have someone watch you while you're doing this exercise. Besides, you can start with partial climbs and just go halfway up the rope. Also, don't forget to put several mats under the rope in case of an accident. If your ultimate goal is to have strong, well-defined muscles, physical training isn't the only thing you'll need. Besides doing exercises regularly, you should also follow several other recommendations. Eat regularly and reconsider your diet. To build muscle, you should eat 4 to 5 times a day. Make sure you have 2 to 3 hours between your meals. This way, your body will always have some energy to build muscle. Try to have a meal no less than 2 hours before a workout. It might be a proper meal or a healthy snack. But the main thing is that your body should have enough time to digest the food. Later, it will use the calories during your training. After you finish your workout, munch on a high-protein snack or have a meal rich in protein. The best option is something that contains low-fat yogurt or cottage cheese, eggs, poultry, fish, whey powder, or almond butter. Remember to eat a lot of vegetables throughout the day. Spinach contains glutamine, which is excellent for growing lean muscle. Brussels sprouts are packed not only in protein, but also in fiber. This makes you feel full during the day and in between your workouts. Beetroot is an excellent source of betaine, a compound that's good at repairing damaged joints. Bell peppers contain some protein as well. They're also rich in vitamin C, which is a famous immunity booster. While planning your weekly meals, don't forget about fruit. Bananas, apples, oranges, and melons contain particular nutrients that help muscles to develop. On top of that, they are loaded with fiber, which keeps your hunger at bay. And naturally, lean beef should appear regularly on your plate. It's rich in all the things necessary for muscle growth: high-quality protein, zinc, iron, and B vitamins. Other great sources of high-quality protein are chicken without skin, cottage cheese, and eggs. Make sure you progress. Specialists advise that you do not train for longer than 1 hour if you want to build muscle mass. The main idea is to progress during your workouts, and that's easier said than done. People often increase the duration of their workout sessions rather than add intensity. It's more efficient to either increase the weight you lift or the number of reps within your main program. Change your workout routine every month. If you feel you've reached a plateau where you're not seeing any progress, start to change your rep range every 4 weeks. This way, your body will have to adapt to different stress every month. As a result, you'll be gaining muscle. Now, if you know any other super effective exercises that hit all your muscles at once, share your experience in the comments. Remember to give this video a like and show it to your friends whose life goal has become to grow muscle. And if you subscribe to this channel, you'll permanently move to the bright side of life.